Single wing is to the right for Tennessee. The ball to Majors. He's going to throw a pass. That is complete for a touchdown to the end, Mike LaSorsa.
Flowers is split to the left side and Dalton to the right. In motion to the left comes Chadwick, and back to throw is Warren. He throws across the middle, completes to Flowers, and he's down on the 35-yard line. Richmond Flowers caught that ball. That one was good from Warren to Flowers.
Man in motion to the right, Bainham. King rolls back. King throws across the middle. It is intercepted by Stencil in the 45 to the 40. 35, 30. Cuts to the sidelines for the 20. 15, 10, 5. He is over for a touchdown. Stencil intercepted at about the 35-yard line. He ran down that sideline, came across this side of the field. He was tackled as he went over by Fortier. Tennessee leads 6-0. Charlie Fulton, the magnificent sophomore quarterback from Memphis, Tennessee, calling the signals with the split end left Mills and Wantlin left in the wing and Chadwick in motion to the right. And Fulton throws down to Denny at the 5 or the 4 to the 2-yard line. Austin Denny with that great pair of hands pulled it in. And Tennessee has a first and goal on the 2-yard line of Georgia Tech. Charlie Fulton, the quarterback, calling the signals. Takes, gives to Mitchell, who hurdles over for a touchdown. Stan Mitchell scores.
I say this, the old cannon's getting a workout today. A lot of people didn't think it would happen, but it certainly is.
One into nothing, Tennessee leading now. 3 minutes remain in the third quarter.
Coach Paul Dietzel elects to go for the two-point conversion. The wing is to the right side. Billy Cannon's the man to watch. Mathurin, the quarterback, takes the ball, hands it to Cannon. Cannon on the right side. A hole starts to open. Schaefer trips him. Wing grub, Charlie Severance, and Bill Majors trying to get to stop him in the one-inch line. Tennessee still leads 14-13.